Manju vibe.
So we are wrapping up what we had started. So it's a continuation on what we had started last time. We're still on wave terminologies. We had looked at what the crest is, the amplitude. We also looked at the wavelength, right? So we are finishing, so we are wrapping up with the last three terminologies. So what are those terminologies? So we start by looking at phiri. Not the one you look at when you're dealing with biology. I'll take you to grade 8 one. Or grade 10 physics. You have looked at the pendula. So now if you happen to pull the pendula up to this point, which I'm calling point A, and that's point B and point C. You lift it up to here, then you release it. And then it swings forth. It goes through point B, goes to point C, and then it will have to come back, right?
Yes.
It gets back to A. Now the question is, at which point does it make a complete oscillation? Sure. At which point does it make a complete oscillation?
When
it goes back to A, right?
Yes.
So, in terms of where, when we have the complete oscillation, then we're saying there's what? A wave, one wave has been created or has been made. And then we need to consider the time through which that one wave has been made. So now if we are talking of waves, through the light of waves, you're saying the time it takes for one complete oscillation to be made is what we call a period. Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what we talked about when we are looking at oscillation of a pendulum. Kindo ya swana, alo ambola ningama. Alo ambola ka kama waves. The question is, see that one trying to get the attention of the friend. Stay focused, Moses. Stay focused. So now what I'm saying is the period of the wave is simply the time it takes for one complete what?
Oscillation.
So now we're going to write that one. It's a period. Is the time taken for one complete
wave?
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay.
One complete
vibration of a particle. So in other words, we can also say that it is the time it takes to make one what? One wave.
Modify YouTube.
I want you to be real fast. Now, what are the units in which period is recorded? The unit is simply what? Seconds. So if you are given period, let's say in hours, given in minutes, you need to know that you have to convert it back to what? Seconds. Unit. Unit of period is second. Denoted by S. And then the symbol that denotes the period of the world is T. Okay, so now what's the formula? The formula for determining periods of a web. To say period is equal to time over the number of webs. So symbolically, this could be written as period is equal to time in seconds over number over. So let's move on to the other terminology. Moving on to frequency. I love using a pendulum because it helps you envision things. So now let's check out this one. If we are looking at this pendulum and we are saying this is the starting point, and then we need to have a stopwatch somewhere there so that we record time. So what it is we will lift the pendulum up to this point, which is point A, then we release it. When we release it, it will oscillate forth and backwards, right? So now when it goes for through point B to point C and then back to point A, we can't say it has made one complete oscillation, right?
Yeah.
So we count that one. And then the moment we release it here, we need to take note of, we need to kickstart the stopwatch. So we'll be checking out the time. So it goes like one, it makes one complete oscillation again. And then the moment the time ticks for one second. Ticks for
one second.
We'll stop the oscillations. Then we'll check how many complete oscillations has the pendulum made within what? One second. I think that's laying the foundation. Now, how do we put those in words? With an intent of defining frequency. So you say a frequency is simply the number of what? Waves produced per what? Per second. Okay, let go.
Yeah.
So how do you define frequency?
Frequency is the number of waves produced.
You need to have confidence, right? I want to hear some person speak with confidence. Mananganda, how do you define frequency? I'll give it straight out. Yes? The number of waves produced per second. As simple as that. Let's write that. Now, the thing is, you also need to know the units in which frequency is measured. What are the units of frequency? So frequency is measured in what?
Hertz.
So let's write this one. Step by step. If you're writing the definitions, don't write two. Pick on the one which you can easily remember. So this is more like a paraphrase. You can either go by this one or the second one that I'm going to write. It is. I've seen that. That's what you do. You write two.
Pick on one.
So now, unit of frequency. Symbolically, they say frequency is equal to number of words over t. And let's move on to the last one, which is speed. In Britain, how are you defining speed? Or how did we define speed in Britain? That's the word that the teens are learning about now. How do you define speed? And the thing is, that topic is cross-cutting. It's there even in math.
Yes.
How do you define speed?
It depends on the distance.
rate of change of distance with respect to time. The change of distance with respect to time. Speed. So now, when you're looking at speed under the topic waves, you need to know how to define. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So then, how do you define it when you're looking at waves? So under waves, we define speed as the distance covered by a wave. Did you get that?
Yeah.
The distance covered by a wave per second. Let me write that down. Speed is the distance traveled by a wave in a second. So you can even zoom. What is the unity of speed? Unity. What's the unit? Meters per second. So that is meters per second, which is written like that, right? So the symbol for speed is what? So now what formula do you apply when you've been asked to determine speed of the wave? The formula is written as follows. That is, speed is equal to frequency. The frequency told you. We are looking at waves, so we are not applying the formula that you know, the one you were applying in grade 10, when you were dealing with motions in a straight line. Frequency times what?
100.
Times wavelength. So, symbolically, we'll say, what will be here? What symbol are we going to write here? That's V, right? V is equal to frequency. What's the symbol for frequency?
F.
Times wavelength. Well, that's all there is. We use a Greek letter.
Greek letter.
So that's the formula for finding speed. Now, without wasting so much time, let's get into examples. We'll see how we can resolve questions that have to do with so, example one.
Oh my God, guys. Yeah, I'm somewhere. You must give.
Frequency.
1759.
So normally I love collecting data because when you do that, work becomes much easier. So now let's analyze the question now. The saying, if 100 words are produced in 5 seconds, what is the frequency? So now what they want us to resolve is what? Frequency. So say a frequency under data, we are going to indicate a question mark to show that we don't know the value. And then we check what we've been given, what quantities have been given so far. So number of verbs is equal to what? 100. And then what else has been given?
Time.
So the quantity time has been given. Is 5 what?
5 seconds.
So now having collected that data, we need to figure out the equation that we have to plug in for us to determine frequency. So now, how do you define frequency? We roll back. Because one thing I know is if you are mastering equations, it becomes much difficult for you to remember. But if you're able to define things, you're able to formulate equations from those definitions. So what is frequency?
Now we're made per second.
Second, right?
Yeah.
So from that, you can say frequency is equal to the number of words. Number of words within a specified period of time. Don't worry.
Yes.
So now let's do this. Frequency is equal to, we simply check under data what we have. So number of verbs is equal to what? That's 100 over
5.
Is equal to
20.
Sir?
20.
So 5 more 1 5 more 2 5 more 0. So frequency is measured in hertz.
Hertz. Hertz.
That's the symbol.
Yes.
So
as
simple
as that.
Let's go example 2. Example 2. The wave source of frequency 100 Hz. Emits waves of wavelength 0.10 meters. Question 1. What is the period of the world? What is the ensemble? So the second question reads, a wave source of frequency 100 Hz emits waves of wavelength 0.10. What is the period of the wave?
then the second one, what is the speed of the word? So now what you do is, before you do anything, you have to collect data. When you collect data, it becomes much easier to work out things. So you go like, data, what is it that we've been given in this paper?
Frequency.
Frequency is for two?
Zari.
That's 100 what?
Hens, indiki hens.
Then wavelength is 0.10 meter. So we say solution. That is air. What is it that the word was to withdraw that?
Speed.
Period, right? So it's a period. Now I want to take you back to what I have actually introduced, but something I talked about. So period is equal to time taken over
number of waves.
Now when we check on what we have collected so far, under data, can we apply those quantities in the actual equation?
No.
The equation can't actually solve, right?
No.
Now there's an equation that I left out. When you are asked to find period, yet those quantities that have to be plugged into the equation haven't been given, you need to use this other one. So that one falls under the relation, the relationship between frequency and what? Period. Yeah. So now the formula that we use here is the same period is equal to 1 over what? Frequency. The one? You just have to mark this formula. Period is equal to 1 over what? So if frequency has been given, then we can determine the period. Say period is equal to 1 over what? What's the frequency?
Time.
So if you find your grandmama's calculator, then you divide the 100 into 1. When you look at it, now, the thing is, we are looking at period. What's the unit of period?
Second.
In physics, it's very important to write the formula, or to know the units. And then you get them correctly. We solved it. Let me solve it from there, right from there. So now, we are solving B, which is saying, what is the speed of the web? What is the speed of the web? What's the speed of the web? So we need to write the equation. How would you write the equation of speed?
Speed
is equal to? Then we can collect the data. What's the frequency?
100. 0.100.
So from there we can plug in the values, right?
Yes.
So if you know equations, then you're able to read with understanding. Things become much easier. The frequency is 100 and 0.10. Then the speed of the world is equal to?
Oh.
He almost stopped her. To normal life, just live it like.
So the answer is
Kenya. Is that jump? No, it's Brazil.